हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजे इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 157। एप्पल इज प्रिपेयरिंग टू लॉन्च न्यू आईफोन्स। ए न्यू सर्वे हैज रिवील्ड दैट नियरली 44% ऑफ करंट आईफोन यूजर्स इंटेंड टू अपग्रेड टू एन आईफोन 13 मॉडल। अकॉर्डिंग टू ए न्यू सर्वे बाय सेलसेल, 43.7% ऑफ आईफोन यूजर्स सेड दैट प्लान टू स्विच टू आईफोन 13, विच इज 2.7% कंपेयर्ड टू द आईफोन 12 परचेज इंटेंड फ्रॉम अ सर्वे ऑफ लास्ट ईयर। वेयर एज 56.3% रिवील दैट दे आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन द अपकमिंग आईफोन रेंज। MI Mix 4 is the company's first phone with the under-display selfie camera. The key specifications include a Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 Plus processor, 108MP primary camera and a 3D curved AMOLED display. This smartphone comes with a 6.67-inch screen with a flagship support of 4500mAh battery with 120W wired fast charging and a 50W wireless charging. Along with the other launches, today at the launch event, Xiaomi officially unveiled the Pad 5 series, its first tablet in 3 years. The lineup consists of a Wi-Fi-only vanilla Pad 5 and the Pad 5 Pro that has both Wi-Fi and a 5G-enabled version. The Pro runs on Snapdragon 870 while the Pad 5 settles on Snapdragon 816, meaning they are among the most powerful Android laptops out there. Both the tablets come with an 11-inch display with a 120Hz refresh rate. The 10-bit panel comes with a support for Dolby Vision and HDR 10 and promise up to 500 nits brightness. The pill-shaped camera island on the Pad 5 holds a single 13-megapixel shooter, while the Wi-Fi only Pro has a 13-megapixel main and a 5-megapixel ultra-wide combo. The Pro 5G on the other hand upgrades the main camera to a 50-megapixel sensor while retaining the 5-megapixel ultra-wide unit. The entire Pad 5 lineup supports a magnetic keyboard, covers a stylus just like the latest iPad 11 Pro and the Samsung Tab S7. If we talk about the battery, the Pad 5 Pro has a 8600mAh capacity and comes with a 67W fast charging ever in a tablet. The non-Pro Pad 5 comes with a slightly bigger 8720mAh cell, but it is downgraded to the 33W fast charging, still quite rapid for a tablet. Xiaomi is great at keeping secrets when it wants to. For example, the first MI Mix phone was a surprised announcement when it was unveiled 5 years ago. Today, Xiaomi has unveiled another surprise product, one we had no linking of prior to its unveiling today. The CyberDog is a quadrupled robot that you can call the manufacturer's own version of Boston Dynamics Spot Robot Dog. CyberDog can be controlled in 3 ways, via the mobile phone app, voice control and a remote control pictured below the sold separately. Only a handful of Xiaomi phones, including the Redmi K40 Gaming Edition, Redmi K40, Redmi K30 5G, Redmi 10X Pro, Redmi 10X and MI Mix 2S are supported at this moment. Xiaomi says compatibility for more devices will be added in the future. If we talk about the cost and the availability, while Boston Dynamics Spot sells for $74,500, while Xiaomi CyberDog sells for a fraction of that, 9,999 yuan, that is around $1,541. Xiaomi on yesterday evening held a highly anticipated launch event in China, where it unveiled the premium Xiaomi Mix smartphone alongside the Mi Pad 5 series. It also launched the Xiaomi CyberDog and its second generation OLED TV. Xiaomi also announced what it is called as first high-end smart speaker. This gadget bears the moniker Xiaomi Sound, and despite the appellation of a high-end speaker, it arrives with a fairly decent price tag of 499 yuan, that is $77. Xiaomi claims that it can achieve 90 decibel shock sound pressure and 70 Hz full bass. At the same time, it adopts 360-degree omnidirectional sound output, a top-mounted sound guide cone design, and it is having a high-resolution certification. Another interesting feature is that the speaker supports 2 interconnections, combined stereo and even 8 interconnections as well. That means you can link up to 8 different speakers together, which can be placed at different locations to achieve the robust sound experience. Apart from the Bluetooth connectivity, the smart speaker also supports a ultra-wide band connectivity, and Xiaomi has implemented with the Harman audio effects for the speakers. Realme has been teasing the Realme Book since June, and it announced that the laptop will be fully unveiled on August 18th in China at 3 PM of their local time. On the same day, Realme will introduce the Realme GT series in India, and it's currently unclear that the Realme Book will be announced in the company's biggest market or will remain the China's exclusive initially. The Realme GT Master Edition that was launched in China last month will debut in India on August 18. Realme today announced that it will also be introduced in Europe on the same day to celebrate the milestone of reaching 100 million users. The GT Master series consists of GT Master Edition and the GT Master Explorer Edition, but it will only be the Master Edition that will make its way to the old continent and Realme's biggest market, India. Realme C3 getting Android 11 based Realme UI 2.0 update in India. To recall, the Realme C3 was the first Realme phone to ship with a Realme UI based on Android 10 last year. The improvements of this update includes updates to Realme UI 2.0, bug fixes, improvement in stability and also patches some fixes. This update is being made available in a phased manner and will be available to users eventually. The Vivo IQ8 series is coming on August 17th and the 8 Pro will bring a Snapdragon Triple 8 Plus and Samsung E5 OLED with a LTPO controller capable of 1 to 120Hz variable frame rate adjustment. Vivo is teasing the cameras of the IQ8 Pro in the new poster. The main unit has 50MP resolution while the ultra-wide lens sit over 48MP sensor. The third camera could be a mid-zoom options reaching up to 60mm or up to 2.5 times. The main camera comes with a Vivo's VIS 5-axis stabilization covering all the possible movements. OnePlus Harry Potter edition to launch in India soon. The limited edition model will come with 6 exclusive watch faces including Hogwarts, Hogwarts Seals, Gryffindor, Slytherin, Hufflepuff and Ravenclaw. OnePlus Harry Potter edition's exact launch date is yet to be revealed. Vodafone Idea has launched ₹449 prepaid recharge plan with a 4GB daily data limit. The plan offers a 1-year subscription to ZEE5, unlimited calls to any network and a 56 days validity. The latest prepaid recharge pack is available for users across the country and can be recharged through the Vodafone Idea website. Battlegrounds Mobile India has banned over 336,000 players on account of malpractice. Account has been taken in just 7 days from 30th July to 5th August. Battlegrounds Mobile India plans to enforce a healthy online competitive zone for all players. Amazon and Flipkart had approached the Karnataka High Court to quash the order by the Competition Commission of India on the grounds that there were no agreements between the platforms and sellers on record that were shown to likely have the negative impact on competition. The Competition Commission of India had in 2020 ordered an investigation into allegation that Amazon and Flipkart had exclusive agreements with the smartphone brands for the sale of certain devices on their platforms and the alleged links of this platform had their sellers who were said to be getting preferential treatment. A day before its Galaxy Unpacked event, Samsung announced a new chipset for wearables dubbed Exynos W920. The processor is set to power the upcoming Galaxy Watch 4 series as well as the future Samsung wearables to come. It's built on 5-nanometer EUV process armed with 2 ARM Cortex A55 cores and an ARM Mali G68 GPU. And Samsung claims a 20% of CPU improvements over the preceding Exynos W9110 and the 10-fold graphics boost. The new chip also packs a dedicated Cortex M55 core processor for handling always-on display use. Google One offers a VPN service to its users, but it was limited to the United States until now. Finally, Mountain View decided to expand to 7 more countries in Europe and North America, but it is still limited to subscribers with at least 2 TB in their plan. The lucky markets are Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Mexico, Spain, and United Kingdom, and the price to switch is $10 per month or $99 per year. The Honor Magic 3 smartphone is expected to arrive on August 12th and will have a Snapdragon 888 Plus chipset. The brand has now announced a partnership with IMAX enhanced on its Weibo page, where an image of a film reel was posted which looks a lot like a circular camera setup, which is similar to what we have already seen in the previous leaks. There's a few more phones set to debut later this week with the Honor X20 5G and the Magic 3 series. The former has now appeared in the listing on the brand's official online shop in China, complete with the detailed specification sheet. The X20 5G sports a 6.67 inch LCD with a 120Hz refresh rate and a pill-shaped cutout in the top left corner with a 16MP main camera. This device packs a MediaTek Dimensity 900 chipset paired with a 6GB or 8GB of RAM or 128 or 256GB of storage, which is further expandable via micro SD card. The Honor X20 5G is listed in black, blue and silver colors. The only remaining question marks of phone are its pricing and its availability. We will be knowing after this Thursday's event. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.